I want to ask you, Father Cedric Prakash, the fact is the charge sheet itself claims that Father Swami was in some way helping financing Maoists. So they are linking the financing of Maoists to the violence that took place in Bhima Koregaon and suggesting that the likes of Father Swami were financing Maoist activities in Jharkhand and beyond. How do you respond?
Ranjit, this is absolutely ridiculous. A citizen of India, an 83-year-old man who has given his life for the Adivasi, who has worked for them, for their right, with passion, wanted for them the jungle or jameen, roti kapda or makan, and today fabricated cases are being put on them, on him. For 15 hours he has been grilled over a period of days. He has been interrogated. They have found absolutely nothing wrong. So where does Stan get his money? Some months ago, they took all his personal possessions. It was practically nothing. He was living a very, very frugal life. And how can, these are all fabricated things. They have reached a ridiculously low level.
No, why would they fabricate it against Father Swami? Why would Father Swami be seen as someone whom the NIA, the country's premier investigation agency when it comes to so-called anti-terror activities, why would they arrest an 83-year-old? What is the nature of the vendetta they would have against Father Swami?
See, I guess it's very difficult to try to understand why they are doing it. But many of us, civil society people, feel that they would want to. There's so much of fear in the country today. Everybody knows that. And once you try to incarcerate a person like Stan Swami, okay, you have literally kind of created a fear psychosis among the tribals he was serving, among the Adivasis. They have been fighting for their rights. He has been supporting them. And if they can do it to him, so the basic message is being sent out to the others. We can do it to any one of you tomorrow. And this is, I think, a very, very serious, a very painful message sent to the people of India today.
You know, in the Bhima Koregaon case, one strand is of various individuals who have worked very hard in Adivasi areas, the likes of Professor Sudha Bhardwaj, for example, who's been in jail for more than two years, that all of them in some form or the other, according to the police charge sheet, were inciting people, giving provocative speeches over the years, and have conspired with the Maoists, either through funding them or financing them. And the allegation against Father Stan Swami is that he was actively involved in the activities of the CPI Maoists and was in contact with these conspirators, that this was a grand conspiracy that eventually led to loss of life and property in Bhima Koregaon. How do you respond to this conspiracy theory which is being woven?
See, this conspiracy theory can be said about anyone at any time. I'm saying this is a very sad state of affairs. I have friends from across the board. Just because a friend commits a crime, that doesn't make me complicit with the crime of that person. Where, it's far away. Or even if I've got an email from them, that doesn't mean. And today, the people whom they have been putting in jail, the likes of Sudha Bharadwaj, Anantel Tumde, Vernon Gonsalves, Arun Ferreira, the people from the Kabir Kala bunch, are people who have stood up for the rights of people. Basically, the message being sent is not about you're supporting them financially, involved with the terrorist activities of these so-called groups, which is, I think, fabricated, but you're taking a stand for the legitimate rights of the people, which the Constitution of India guarantees, and which all of us have a right, to be supporting.
Okay. So, fair enough, Father. You've, in a sense, suggested that this is therefore a complete overreach of the law and totally unfair. You believe that this is an attempt being made to silence dissent and critical voices. Unfortunately, as I said, the police was unwilling to come. I appreciate you joining me, though.